Good morning. My name is Miron Tokarski. I'm a co-founder and CEO of Genomtec. My background is laboratory medicine, which I studied on Wrocław Medical University, and then started my PhD also at the Wrocław Medical University. And this is the place that I have met with two other colleagues from Wrocław University of Technology and Wrocław Medical University. And in late 2016, we started Genomtec, starting developing our Genomtec ID platform for point of care genetic testing to provide the right diagnosis right away and, of course, at the right price. Right now, the team has grown quite substantially. The top management team, except of me, co-founder and CEO, is also Chavdat Sah, our chief business officer. Very experienced person in marketing and sales in companies like bioMérieux, Luminex, Spartan Biosciences. And also I'm supported by Michał Wachowski, our chief financial officer, and the rest of the management team, our chief marketing officer, Magda, Jason Rees, our current CTO, who has experience in developing point of care systems that include microfluidic cartridges, in companies like Novartis. He also worked in PerkinElmer, Beckman Dickinson, and other higher profile IVD, MDR companies. And we are also supported by Charles, or Bolesław in Polish, our chief product officer, who works hand on hand with Chardat on the commercialization and sales of our current and future products. Genomtec, as I mentioned, was established in late 2016, and at the beginning of last year, we have gone through the IPO stage at Warsaw Stock Exchange. We have two offices. The main office and headquarters is located in Wrocław in Poland, but the substantial part of our engineering team is located in Kent in UK, where they are focused on industrialization of our mobile genetic analyzer, working hand-on-hand with our CDMO partner, also located in UK. So in total, there are over five people working in UK right now. But what is the true cause of the idea behind Genomtec? And this is the length it takes for a genetic test to be provided to a patient and a doctor in order to react with a proper targeted therapy. Right now, when the patients show up in the doctor's office and is referred to a genetic testing, the sample needs to be collected. Usually, in many cases, it happens in an external facility. Then the transport is needed to move the sample to a well-equipped laboratory. And in the lab, it usually takes around 4 hours to prepare the sample, purify nucleic acids, and set up the reactions. And after around 4 hours, the result is ready and can be provided by the doctor. But the time that passes from the first visit to the availability of the result is usually between 24 hours up to even 2 weeks, depending on the pathogen that is diagnosed. With our mobile solution, we can have the test for up to five different pathogens performed right in the doctor's office. So we take a sample, for example, swab from a throat, then place the sample into the microfluidic reaction cart, insert the cart into our analyzer, and press run. The test usually takes between 15 to 25, 30 minutes. The analytical phase is vastly reduced, and the system is fully automated. So also, nurses, doctors, or paramedics are able to run the test on our platform. After this 15 minutes, the test is available to the doctor so that he can react and introduce a proper targeted therapy. The quality of the results is very similar to the PCR, as this is, let's say, more novel technology that does not require thermal cycling. And the reaction takes one single temperature. In that way, we are able to shrink down the size of the analyzer and also reduce the energy consumption and, of course, time. So how it is possible that we are able to shrink down the size of genetic analyzer that usually weighs couple of kilos into a small form factor device and into a cartridge like that you can see on the screen. So it is based on our patented photonic contactless heating detection system. This system enables us to build a passive microfluidic reaction cart that you can see here on the left down corner. The cart is truly passive. It means that there are no active elements like sensors, heaters, or any other electronic components embedded into the reaction cart. This is just a piece of a plastic with the reagents, either freeze-dried or liquid. And because of the precise technology of optical heating, we are able to heat only specific areas of microfluidic reaction cart to a specific temperature. So at the top of the reaction cart here, you can see three different circles. And each of the circle contains three separate reaction chambers, and each circle can be heated to specifically designed and the proper temperature for those assays that are used for the detection of pathogen. In that way, we are able to maintain the proper temperature and proper performance of our assays. Thus, we are able to improve the specificity and sensitivity of our assay. Also, because this reaction cart is truly passive, we can significantly reduce cost associated with production. And of course, thanks to the microfluidic itself, we are able to introduce this system to a point of care solution without any additional equipment needed for to run the test. On our side are the highest quality of enzymes and primers that we develop on our own. And they enable us to shorten the amplification time and reduce the limit of detection so that we can detect the pathogen earlier. And we do not need to wait a couple of days for the symptoms to develop. And as I mentioned, the shelf life of this reagent is at least 6 months, and they are freeze-dried. The thermal label reagents are freeze-dried so that the reaction cart can be shipped and stored in room temperature for almost 6 months. So what are our ambitions? So with our technology, we are targeting both the centralized and decentralized systems. Decentralized system like local clinics, physician offices, pharmacists, or in the future patients' homes are really the best places to incorporate our analyzers, simply because our system does not require sophisticated equipment. It can be waiting for the patient on the desk of a doctor. However, we are also able to address the needs of ICU emergency departments for a point of care systems or hospital stat laboratories where the result of the test is needed as soon as possible. Of course, there is also possibility that smaller hospitals might be interested with this system. Those hospitals whose throughput of genetic testing is lower than the high profile laboratories in big clinical centers. The market of genetic testing is still growing. And here you can see that the combined growth will be approximately 5.4% throughout 2027. And it is really worth to mention that this growth rate was calculated without COVID. So it does not include the COVID and the changes to the market that COVID caused. And with COVID opportunity, the market is even bigger, and the understanding of a proper test that should be performed in order to introduce proper therapy or to isolate a patient is even stronger than it was before, prior to the pandemic. So this market is substantially growing. And if you will look at the microfluidic-based point of care testing market, the molecular assays that we use that detect DNA or RNA of a target are growing in the fastest rate, are the biggest portion of this microfluidic-based point of care market. So what is our pipeline? Our first respiratory panel, the 5X panel, will enter the market in the middle of this year. And in this panel, we will be able to detect two atypical bacteria that cause community-acquired pneumonia. together with three viral infections. I'm talking about the flu, SARS-CoV-2, and RSV. Further down the road, we plan to introduce to the market our STI panel for sexually transmitted infections with future life-threatening systematic infections like sepsis or Lyme disease, and to be introduced in the next couple of years. If we will look at the competitors of Genomtec, the vast majority of them either provide very expensive equipment that is, of course, fully automated. However, more intended for use in the laboratory itself because of the cost and number of samples that those laboratories are performing, then it is, let's say, viable to invest in such automated systems. However, for smaller laboratories or GPs where the number of samples is lower, when the samples are not acquired 24 hours a day, the cost of tens of thousands of euros is simply too much. With our system, we are able to reduce the price to around $2,500 or euros. So that this is a substantial reduction. We can say that this is around 10% of the price of the current analyzers for a point of care from our competitors. Other group of competitors like Q Health or Abbott ID Now, they are not providing the ability to test for multiple pathogens from a single sample. So if a doctor wants to distinguish between flu and SARS-CoV-2, which exhibits similar symptoms, they need to run two tests and collect two samples from the patient. And also it requires more effort to collect the sample. It requires additional time, so 15 or 20 minutes times two. And also it requires the expenditure for this test to be much higher than with a multiplex system. So as I mentioned, where we are right now, on the final stage of the industrialization of our system. We have started clinical performance studies a few days ago, and we intend to bring the device to the market and certify according to in vitro diagnostic directive prior to the end of May of 2022. Then we will focus on a small and medium scale production in order to start the sales activities with our system and also focus on developing additional panels. In 2023, we expect that we will apply for the certification of FDA, but of course, more comprehensive clinical studies performed in the US will be needed. It's worth to mention that in 2021, we have received the ISO 13485 certification that guarantees that all of our research and development procedures are met, are run according to this standard, and we meet all the standards of developing clinical devices. We also intend to focus on medium to large scale production in 2023. And it is also worth to mention that the regulatory submission for the IVDR is also something that we are looking at further down the road. And thanks to the ISO 13485 certification, we are able right now to meet the requirements of the IVDR regulation. So no redesign, no updates to the documentation will be needed. All of our procedures, all of our documentation is already suitable for regulatory submission according to the new regulation for the IVD industry in Europe. So thank you very much. Of course, if you have questions, please feel free to mail us at investors@genomtec.com. Thank you very much.
Hi there, since you watched this company video until the end, I'm guessing you liked the video, and that's probably because we work very hard to create the most engaging and added value content for you. If you're a company and want to find out how we, at Seat 11A, can make a company video with and about you, please email us at content@seat11a.com.